This on CNBC-TV18. Well, 2.2 crore small and marginal farmers have received the first installment of the Prime Minister Kisan scheme so far. But the data shows that UP has cornered the lion's share of this dispersal, with money transferred to around 75 lakh farmers from the state. Sapna Das joins in with more details. Sapna, tell us, what are you picking up, and give us the details of the breakup of this disbursement so far.
Well, probably this was on the expected lines, is what we were given to understand earlier as well, from various sources indicating that probably the database of Uttar Pradesh is more robust. Having said that, the numbers are right there. 74.71 lakh small and marginal farmers have received funds under the PM Kisan. 2.18 crore is where the number stands as of March 7. Let's look at the other states, how they have fared. Well, Andhra Pradesh comes at a late second, 32 lakh small and marginal farmers getting those funds. Gujarat around 26 lakh, Telangana 14 to 15 lakhs, Tamil Nadu 14 lakhs, Maharashtra not even 12 lakh, Haryana around just slightly over 8 lakh. So this is the kind of ranking that we are talking about in terms of the number of farmers who have actually received the PM Kisan funds as of March 7. Let's look at the middle rung states, and here again the gap really widens. You have Jammu and Kashmir doing pretty well at 3.41 lakh small and marginal farmers getting these funds. Punjab is 2.63 lakh. Uttarakhand is 2.98. Not bad for such a small state. Well, the laggards clearly over here would be Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, and West Bengal. Apparently, for West Bengal, the status is zero as of now, which basically means that in terms of identification of the small and marginal farmers, the government, probably the state, has yet to get back. Hence, no payment has actually been made. That's what it indicates. In terms of Karnataka and Madhya Pradesh, the story may be slightly different. The finance minister's tweet says, 60,000 beneficiaries for Karnataka. What we are given to understand from Agriculture Ministry is that basically these are the number of people, the list that has been received from the state. If you start doing the filtering and the eligibility norms kick in, basically the transfer of funds would hardly be any. So probably the number, stands at a much lower level as of now. But these are dynamic numbers. March 7 is what we are talking about. Going forward, we have to keep a watch as to how the numbers really pan out. But definitely, UP has taken a straight sprint, well ahead of all the other states, in fact, put together.
Okay, Sapna, thank you so much for that. But on to the big political story. Just a day after the government told the Supreme Court that the Rafale file notings have been stolen, Congress President Rahul Gandhi has launched an attack on the Prime Minister. Now, calling for a probe against the Prime Minister, Rahul Gandhi accused him of having conducted a bypass surgery on the Rafale deal to benefit Anil Ambani. He also slammed the government for threatening to invoke the Official Secrets Act against media organizations that publish reports based on government file notings, which the centre now claims have been stolen. Now, the BJP hit back at Rahul Gandhi, calling Gandhi a dynast. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley said that Congress president cannot be above the Supreme Court and the CAG.
जिसके बारे में फाइल में साफ लिखा है कि पैरेलल नेगोशिएशन हो रहा था, उनके बारे में कोई इन्वेस्टिगेशन नहीं होगा. बेसिक आइडिया है कि किसी चीज को भी मरोड़कर बदलकर नरेंद्र मोदी जी का बचाव करना है, कोई भी इंस्टीट्यूशन हो. और किसी एक व्यक्ति ने नहीं, सब लोगों ने कहा है, नेगोशिएशन टीम ने कहा है कि नरेंद्र मोदी ने बाईपास सर्जरी की है. एक नई लाइन निकली है, गायब हो गया, 2 करोड़ युवाओं का रोजगार गायब हो गया, किसानों को सही दाम गायब हो गया, 15 लाख रुपए का जो वायदा था, पैसा जो बैंक अकाउंट में आना था, वो गायब हो गया, किसानों के बीमा का पैसा गायब हो गया, नोटबंदी और जीएसटी में कारोबार गायब हो गया, ढोकलाम गायब हो गया, और राफेल की जो फाइलें हैं गायब हो गई.
No dynast can claim that he is above the Supreme Court or the CAG, and those verdicts and findings don't apply to him. The facts were completely wrong, And the motivation was also collateral. The Congress Party has in the last few days, through statements of its senior leaders, boxed itself into a corner in a very difficult situation. They are getting high TRPs in Pakistan television, on Pakistan television.
Okay, now let's talk about the big national news that came in last night. Congress has released the first list of 15 candidates for the Lok Sabha elections. And contrary to many speculations, Sonia Gandhi will be contesting for the Lok Sabha seat from Rae Bareli. Pallavi Ghosh now joins us on the phone line with all those details. Pallavi, tell us more.
It's very clear that this time it's not Priyanka Gandhi Vadra, but certainly Sonia Gandhi continues to contest from Rae Bareli, which really has been her constituency. That I would say very, very significant because, you know, it puts to rest all that speculation. But more importantly, it makes it clear that Priyanka Gandhi's work is now cut out for her, that her concentration would be to strengthen the organization and, of course, the next assembly elections in the state in 2022. I think the message which they want to send out is by putting out all these names is that the Congress is not going to be happy with settling to contest only in two seats of Rae Bareli and Amethi. They feel that these are the seats in which actually the Congress Party can win, and therefore they don't need to depend on the SC-BSC rollout. And that, I think, is one big message which the Congress is trying to send out and trying to get their best foot forward, trying to get all those people who they think can do it and deliver for them in Uttar Pradesh.